Hello Shopify store owners, welcome back with another video. I'm your host Bilal Nasir with a new video, and in this video you will learn how to add stylish preloader and add in the functionality of lazy load to improve SEO of your store, and all of this without any coding knowledge. Yes, you heard it right, you won't be needing to code. All you have to do is just follow this video, subscribe to this channel obviously if you want to learn more, and follow the instructions which I'm going to tell you to add in lazy load functionality, improve SEO of your store, and add cool looking preloaders. You can also upload your own custom preloaders using this app which I'm going to show you guys. So the app which I'm talking about today is Loadify, and I'll be installing this app on my development store and show you guys how it's going to look. So without further ado, let's get into the screen. Now guys, once you install this app, you will be seeing a page like this where you can set up your own custom preloader. Now let's test some of the preloaders and see how it looks. So I'm going to open my online store in a new tab. And you can see that it loaded everything at once. So it doesn't have the lazy load functionality yet, right? And it doesn't even have a preloader. So what I'm going to do, I'll just open this app and try some of the preloaders which they have provided us. So select any one of them. Let's check this one out. So that's a heart. Looks like my heart. You can change, or you can also change the color of that, and it will also show you the live preloader here. So let's click on save and see how it looks. Okay, so you can see that's the live preview of how it's going to look like. And so animate image is the option for your custom preloader. If you want to add your own logo as a preloader, you can upload that image here and it will be animated based on the animation which you are seeing on this dropdown. So let's first visit how this preloader looks like on our store. So that's the store, and I'm going to hit refresh. Okay, so that's how our preloader will look like. You can see it's looking really cool, right? I'm going to hit refresh again. And now once this preloader is gone, you can see my page is instantly loaded. So it's really good if you are looking to add some more attraction to your store. And let's check out some other preloaders which we have. So we have this heartbeat. Okay, that one's also looks cool. And we can also change the colors here. So you can match this as per your logo. I'm going to play with the colors to see which one looks cooler. Okay, that one looks good. Now let's try this one and see how that one looks on our store. I'm going to hit refresh again. And you can see that it shows the preloader first. And once the preloader is loaded, once the preloader is gone, your store is completely loaded. And we have lots of other variations. Let's check out some other one. That's a plain free Chrome loader. Okay, that's a Vimeo loader. It's similar to Vimeo. These are all of the free ones which you will be getting for free. Now I'm going to review the paid ones because I have the paid app stored, and you will be getting these paid one on the paid version. So let's check out some of the paid one. Looks nice, right? Great. We can also do some color changes here. Okay, that one is funny. So we have a hamster on the wheel. Nice. Colorful fan. Loading bar. Triangle. Loading circle balls. Loading the line dots. Nice. That one also looks cool. So pretty cool preload multiple types of preloaders without any coding. You won't have to add in the JS or CSS code, because if you do something like this on your store with the code, you'll need to have a lot of JS code added and the CSS code added. And when you update your theme, obviously all of that code is removed. So you'll have to re-update that code again. In the case, if you are using this app, you won't be needing to do that frequent update of the coding, and it will automatically be applied on all of your published and live themes. You don't have to play with the code at all. And they also have this custom image. Let's check out the custom image one. So I'm going to upload my logo to see how it looks. Okay, so that's my logo. And let's hit save. And now we will animate our image from this section here. So let's check out what are the animations we have in case of custom animation. I have selected zoom in out and I'm going to save it. Nice. Now let's go to the store and see how it looks. I might need to add a little better quality for the preloader because it's looking a little blur, but I have used a shorter version. You can use the high quality version in order to make it look better. And let's see how the 360 spin looks like. So these are the animation for our custom image, which we'll upload. So that's the fade in, zoom out, 360 spin, front flip, pose spin. Cool. And here's the logic of the preloader. So if you don't want it to auto hide, so what it does, it automatically hides the preloader when your page is completely loaded. But if you don't want that to happen and you want to manually hide it after 1 second or 2 seconds or even 0.7 seconds, you can do that as well via the settings. And you can also select when do you want to load the preloader. So if you want load that preloader only once per user session, you can do that as well. Once per user session, meaning that if the user is visiting the second time on the website, it won't be seeing that. It will just see that when it visited for the first time, which is called once per user session. And once per user session single page, meaning if person have visited this page again and refreshed it, it won't be seeing it second time. But if it goes to the second page or a different page, he or she will be seeing that preloader. So these are the setting which we can have. And so that's the light version. So if you add in the light version, it will have no effect at your speed at the loading time at all. Currently it adds a few seconds if you are not using the light version. Okay, what are the options which we have? We can also add page transitions here. So you can see we have normal slide. So click on view transition to see what are the page transitions. So if you switch from page to page, it will have a different transition effect, right? So that's how the normal slide works. And let's check out the teardrop. Looks cool. Filling tears, that one's nice. Old TV. Cool. Let's check out the filling tears, apply that on our store and see how it looks. Okay, we can also add sound to our page transitions. That's also really cool. So I'm just going to hit save and see how the page transitions work. First, I'm going to hit refresh and then I'm going to switch the page to see how it works. Okay, did you see that it happening? So once the page is reloaded, there's this transition and then we have our preloader. In page transition, we can also change the direction. So we can switch it from top, from right, bottom, and let's view how it looks when we change it. So it's currently from right. Let's move it to from bottom, normal slide, click on view transition to see if it changes it. Okay, I think we'll have to save it and visit how it works from if someone clicks on from bottom and from top or from right. These are other page transition settings. So now it shows the bottom. Okay, so it's showing up from here. This one is just showing the transition animation, and this one is showing after when we add the direction. Okay, perfect. We can also add sounds. Here we have more settings to enable disable animation before entering a new page. So if you just want to add it on the website load, you can do that as well. And if you want to add entering a new page, you can set up the setting here. And here we have the optimization settings. So if you just click on preloader plus optimization, these are the settings which I discussed on the intro of the video. So link predict is the setting where if someone hover over a link on your store, it will automatically load the assets of that page, which will drastically improve the website speed, the page speed which the visitor will be visiting. So that's a really cool setting, an important setting which will help you increase your Shopify store speed. And the other one is the lazy load. So images are only loaded when you actually visit those images and when you actually scroll over those images. So these are the optimization settings which you can implement using this app. And you can also choose if you want to specifically show a preloader on one single page, or if you have specific pages which you want to show preloader and the rest of the website you don't want to show preloader. So you can do these settings here as well. So you'll just click on select and select the pages of your store where you want to display the preloader. So that's it for the video, guys. I wanted to show you guys this really cool app which I found. And if you want to install that and try that on your store, link will be in the description. Until next video, have a great day.